the other way. And that will be the first hit for the Athletics thus far.
Batting fifth, first baseman, Matt Olson.
Stepping in, Matt Olson. He'll get to take his first cuts here. First offering on its way. A high fastball is in there.
Zero.
And he chased up and out of the zone, a swing and a miss.
You know, that can really be an effective pitch to a guy that has a lot of pop. They're up there looking for a fastball up in the zone, so if you can place it a little above it, they have a hard time getting the barrel up there.
And he missed with it. It's one and two.
He still might be looking for that release point on that curveball early in this outing. That one looked like it popped out of his hand behind his ear instead of out front. We'll see if he finds that pitch because it'll be important for him.
The 1-2 misses for the second ball.
Boy, if you're going to throw a pitch like that to this guy, you have to make sure it's up above the zone like that. He can't do a whole lot with that, but if it were a little lower, he can and will make you pay big time.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first down.
Okay, here's how the Rays set up on defense today. And let's take a look at outfielder Denard Span. Can he play center field the way he used to in his Minnesota days? Probably not. But what he does is make up for it with savvy and smarts and baseball acumen. Look for him to make a big play on defense today.
Striding in for Oakland, Matt Joyce. First pitch coming, here it is.
Ball one,
over on the face. Fastball that just misses inside. Here he comes on 2-0. Looking at a fastball for a strike on the corner. Now he spins on one here and drives it to deep right field. And that is off the wall in right field. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
As we take a look at this one, you can see he puts a good swing on it, but I don't think he got her just enough to put some backspin to get it out of here. But hard to complain about a well-hit double, though.
Outfielder Stephen Piscotty the next to hit. First pitch misses high and inside for ball one. And he's a guy looking to break out in a big way. Hasn't been getting the results he or his club have been hoping for. Now the 1-0. Fastball taken high for a ball. Piscotty has a history in coming through in the clutch moments, of course. It's always a little bit of a debate whether or not being clutch is actually a trait that a player possesses. But with him, there's no denying it. We've seen him deliver in big moments repeatedly throughout his career. It just seems he elevates his game somehow, and the pressure is on.
Yeah, Matty, he has definitely put that debate to rest. He has absolute ice water.
The run is in to score, and they take an early 1-0 lead.
Got his job done there and made it look pretty simple. batted into the outfield to bring home the first run of the game and pick up the RBI.
So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman. And as you take a look at the splits here, he's actually better against right-handed pitching this season. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. 1-0, too low, 1-0.
Joyce
on third with two out. Hit well on the ground to first. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. A's have to settle for just the one. We'll go now to the top of the third. The A's lead this one 1-0. Welcome back to Oakland as we're set for the start of the third from the Coliseum here on MLB Network. Leading off the inning, Pesky. And they'll need him to get something going here.
Pesky.
First delivery to him on the way. And the slider is blowing inside as he just about got him there. And that pitch misses in the dirt, and it's 2-0 now.
You know, sometimes it takes a pitcher a few pitches to get going, but those two pitches weren't even close. Ball's behind in the count, 2-0. It's time to start getting locked in.
Pretty good cut there, but it's to 2-1 now. Now the 2-1 pitch. And this is on the ground for Lowry, short. Bit of a high throw that time, but no problem over there at first as they record the out. So one gone in the inning now. It's time for a look at the standings in the AL West. You just see where the A's find themselves entering play here today. Here's Echeverria now. He comes in after a day of rest yesterday, so we'll see if it did him any good. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Leaves a slider up high, but it's taken for a strike.
So far, this has been a very good outing for this guy. Listen, he doesn't have the best stuff, but what he needs to do, and he's doing it right now, throwing strikes early, trying to initiate a lot of contact. The more pitches that the hitters see off this guy, the better chance they have to go ahead and square something up. So he needs to continue to attack early and get some quick outs, attack the strike zone on the first and second pitch.
And that's the second out.
Now batting, the first baseman, Brad Miller.
Ready now, Brad Miller, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Now here it comes. This should end the inning as it's sent out to second. And indeed it will. He throws him out at first, and the side is retired. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told. We'll head now to the home half of inning number three. The A's lead this one 1-0. Here's the German-born catcher, Bruce
Leading
Maxwell.
Up for the A's.
And as you can see, he's had some troubles here in his own ballpark. That's something he'll look to improve upon in this one. Ready. Here's the first offering. Line towards center field. Kiermaier is right there. One down.
Jumped all over that first pitch. And he didn't miss it. Just wasn't able to steer it in a direction that resulted in a leadoff hit.
Into the box now, Steve Lombardozzi. And takes a look at a breaking ball that misses for ball one. Lombardozzi, the former Miami Marlin, he became a member of this team after signing as a free agent earlier this season.
Yeah, he didn't have an opportunity to really get acclimated to this ball club. Showing up during the season is not always easy, opening his doors to a big league clubhouse and trying to get to know your teammates. The best way to get to know them is to go out and produce.
Now the 2-0 home. Down low, and the plot thickens here. 3-0. There's a strike as he'll try to work his way back. It's 3-1. The 3-1. Finds the zone to fill the count. 3-2.
One out, 3-2.
Bases are empty, one man out. And he lost him here on 3-2 as that pitch misses. It's ball four.
He's going to be pretty upset with himself about that 3-2 pitch. All you want to do in that count is make a competitive pitch, but that one wasn't even sniffing the zone, and he let him get away.
Here's Jed Lowry now, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. First pitch on its way. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball. Ball one. Ready with the 1-0. And it's a fastball on the inside corner.
That's a real good job of going back-to-back fastballs right there. Most of the time, a hitter will see a fastball in the inside half of the plate, and they'll just think, well, this pitcher's going to go back on the outside. But when you double up like he did right there, it sends a message to the hitter that you're not afraid to throw in that inner half of the plate.
Skied in the air to straightaway left. Pesky has it in his tracks. And that's the second out of the inning.
Now batting, center fielder, Ken Griffey Jr.
So a runner at first with two away, and here comes Jr. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Fouled off. And it's a ball and a strike to Ken Griffey Jr. Toward the alley in left center. And a base hit there as Junior's aboard.
Nice execution right there. Kept his balance on a nasty breaking ball. His hands stayed back, and he was able to light it off for base hit.
Here's Chris Davis now. He looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. A base hit in his first trip. Trying to hang a zero. Here's the pitch. Now a ball hit high in the air. Deep down the line in left. Hooking just a little. And nearly a three-run shot. Instead, it's a foul ball. Called strike three, and the side is retired. A's strand a couple, but they're up 1-0. Digging in to try it again, Denard Span. He popped out in his first trip.
Right fielder, Denard Span.
First pitch on its way. Looking at a tough pitch called a strike.
This guy's cruising along, pitching well as we enter the middle innings of this one. Less than 60% of his first pitches have been for strikes. If he can clean that up a little bit, he could really roll into the later innings in this one.
Ball one. And there's a sinker that he just spits on as it misses low. Pulled toward right center field. Chasing after it is Joyce. He makes the catch. A great effort to get there and record the first out of the inning.
The batter, number five, shortstop, Matt Duffy.
Digging in for his second at bat, Matt Duffy. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First delivery to him on the way. Ball. And that sinker misses at the shoetops. Ball one. The 1-0 home. Finds the zone. Strike one.
One ball, one strike.
The 1-1 home. Oh, and ouch. That one drilled him. And a nice job to stay with it that time and get the second out of the inning. And with that play over now, time to check and see if our man is all right. You can really see him favoring that leg. And that is his plant leg, which is always a concern. But from the way he's acting out there, I think it looks like he's going to be okay to try and continue. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Ryan Schimpf. He flew out in his last at-bat. Field shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch.
Ball one, no strike.
Good late break to the slider here, but he takes it in on the hands for ball one. No runs, just one hit, and no errors for Tampa Bay so far. On the ground and right at the shifted infield. Backhanded. A close play at first, but he's called out and the side is retired. Rays go in order. 1-2-3. They're on the short end of a 1-0 score. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. He's 0-for-1 thus far. Here's the first pitch to him. Takes a knee-high fastball.
Hey, it's not always about filling up the strike zone all the time every inning. He's pitching well as we're moving into the middle innings, but interestingly, less than 50% of his first pitches have been for strikes.
Hard hit at third. Throws in time, and that's out number one.
The batter, right fielder, Matt Joyce.
Riding in once again, Matt Joyce. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Right over the middle, knee high.
Hey, this guy has been locating his fastball all game to perfection. Talking to a number of big league pitchers over the years, they'll tell you a well-executed fastball with good location is still the best pitch in the game.
And great extension as he drives this one high in the air and deep the other way. And he pushed it just a bit too much. It'll wind up a foul ball. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. Down the first baseline. And a step on first himself for the out. So with two gone here in the fourth, let's check out our pitch speed comparison for the two starters. And, whoa, you see the big number. How about 99 for a top speed? Not too many guys around the league can match that. Outfielder Stephen Piscotty the next to hit. First pitch of the at-bat. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
You know, Matty, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're seeing guys attack in the philosophy more north-south. Just with launch angles and exit velocities, I think guys are afraid to throw that sinking fastball for fear that guys are just going to run their barrel into it. Not the case with the high fastball.
Tap down the line. Schimpf brings it in. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the A's, but they lead it 1-0. Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos.
Leading
start
off
Tampa the
Bay,
fifth in this one.
The catcher, number 40, Wilson Ramos.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Tough slider over the inside corner for a strike. Hit on the ground out to short. And the fifth inning will start with a ground out, one away.
Up next for Tampa Bay.
A look at our line score here through the first four. And as we mentioned, just one hit for these guys this afternoon. Ready for another chance? Kevin Kiermaier. He drew a walk his first time up. Here comes the first pitch.
Nope.
Wouldn't bite on a good sinker that time that missed.
Counts 1-0.
He pulls this one into right. And he will run this one down. It's a good read off the bat for the second out.
Number eight, designated hitter, Carlos Gomez.
Here's Carlos Gomez. And Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. First pitch of the at-bat. Hit down the third baseline. Diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit.
Boy, dear, it's about time they got something brewing here. First pitch single, and maybe now they can start to get some traffic on the bases.
Yeah, absolutely. Ambush tactics, not always the play. You want to drive that pitch count up and get into that bullpen, but sometimes desperate times call for desperate.
Into the box, Clayton Pesky.
1-0.
Pitch out, nothing doing. The 1-0. Misses ball two. Now the 2-0 home. Grounded down the third baseline. throw in time, and the side is retired. One left for Tampa. It remains 1-0. So that brings up the always intense Matt Chapman. Comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Weakly hit towards first. Miller fields it cleanly, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out.
The catcher, number 13, Bruce Maxwell.
So striding in, Bruce Maxwell hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat. First pitch on its way. Tried to check it, and it's 0-1. Wind up and the 0-1. And there's one well above the zone for a ball. Fastball down near the shoe tops. One run on three hits, and no errors in the ballgame for the A's so far. Popped him up. But this will land untouched. For sure. Duffy loves it. And there are two away now.
Now batting. Second baseman, Team Lombardosi.
So the lineup flips over, and digging in, Steve Lombardosi. It was a walk in his last trip. First delivery to him on the way. Missed with a breaking ball. The 1-0. Fought off at the plate as it's chopped foul.
Classic change of speeds right there. Threw the hitter's timing off. Got a late foul ball. Interested to see where he goes now.
Hit hard towards center. That's his first base hit, making 1-for-2 now. So he delivers with two away, and the bottom of the fifth marches on.
Hey, sometimes you just got to pick that right there. You execute a nice pitch down in the zone. Think you're going to get a ground ball or a swing and a miss, and you find yourself with a man on first. Got to regroup.
Here's Jed Lowry now. 0-for-2 on the afternoon so far. Stretch lifted down the line in left, but no one gets to this one as it lands in the home bullpen. A foul ball. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. Tough slider down low for a strike. Lombardosi is off at first with two away. Shortstop behind with a 1-2 count.
Decided to go with a fastball there on 0-2, but what he's trying to do with that pitch is to expand the strike zone. Maybe you get a guy to offer at it, but at the very least, it helps set up your off-speed stuff.
Swing and a liner. But it drops foul down there in the home bullpen area. third baseline. Well, this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Another 1-2 delivery. Pitch popped up. Schimpf waits on it. He makes the play, and that'll end the inning. The A's strand one, but they hold a 1-0 lead. Here's Echeverria now. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only two hits so far, Matt, and not very many hard hit balls either. We'll see if they can start making some adjustments.
Here comes the first pitch. Swing and a liner. But foul. Aye. That's taken. Now it's 0-2.
You know, when a guy starts to get tired, you often see their breaking stuff start to flatten out, but that's not the case here. Still has really nice finish on that slider, as we just saw.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Hit the other way out toward right field. Joyce coming on, but he's not going to get to it in time. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard.
Now batting.
Hey, sometimes that's how a rally gets started right there. I know it's a soft liner, but leadoff man on usually poses problems.
Stepping in now, Brad Miller. This will go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's 0-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. Ready with the 0-1. And now a slider in on the hands, and he's lucky that one didn't come and get him.
Even though that wasn't a fastball, it's never fun seeing a pitch come right at your head. Your first thing is to dive out of the way. It's not to see if you could see the stitching of the slider and decipher whether or not it's
out in front as he rolls over it to second. And the throw to first is in time, one gone.
Now batting, right fielder, Denard Span.
So stepping in, Denard Span, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. First offering on its way. Just got a piece to the right side. Foul ball, however, strike one. He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Line to the right side. And that's in there. Base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third. So they're runners at the corners now with one away.
Nice piece of hitting right there. Looked like the guy on second had to respect it and freeze a little bit.
They had to freeze there for a second to make sure that line drive gets through. But eventually does get to third base.
Standing in now, Matt Duffy. High and deep to right center. Catch is made. Runner tagging from third. And the tying run is in to score from third. It's 1-1.
That was a good controlled swing out of him there. And that's exactly what he was hoping to do. Get it into the outfield and pick up the RBI.
Stepping in and ready for another shot, Ryan Schimpf. He was a ground out victim last time up. Pitch coming. Here it is. Missed with a slider.
Right here, he's looking to get himself into a good hitter's count so he can take a rip and maybe give his team the lead. He certainly has the power.
The 1-0. Tapper up the line. Will foul for strike one. set. Here comes the 1-1. Very weakly on the ground. Catches a slider that misses 2-2. Spam. Runner at first with two gone. Pulled toward right center field. Chasing after it is Joyce. And that ends the inning. A couple of hits lead to a run here for Tampa Bay. Part of the order, 3, 4, and 5 coming up, all tied at 1-1. Digging in and looking for more, Ken Griffey Jr.
Leading up for the
getting
eight.
Started here in the second
Ken
half of the sixth.
Ken Griffey Jr.
Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch.
Nope.
He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. Now the 1-0. Swung on, missed in that strike one. Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Yeah, it really does, Matt, but this offense isn't helping him too much. It sort of feels like the next team to score is going to win this thing.
Oh, and here's a drive. Well hit out to straightaway center. Kiermaier looks up. Gone! A solo shot for Junior. 24 home runs for him on the season, and the A's have grabbed a 2-1 lead.
Well, it's obvious they didn't change their scouting report after yesterday's game. He had two bombs yesterday and another one today. Hey, this pace can't continue, but he's going to ride this wave as long as he can.
The left fielder.
Here's Chris
number
Davis
two.
Now.
Red Hayman.
First pitch to him is off the plate for a ball 1-0. A hit and two tries for him so far. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. A breaking ball taken at the knees for strike one. One ball and two strikes to count. The 1-2 pitch. Nope. Two balls and two strikes now.
Well, I kind of wonder if he's not being as aggressive as he was before that home run. Hey, this is a guy that can burn you again, so I don't really blame him.
So he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Hey, I know the idea is to try to get the guy to swing on a 2-2 pitch, right? But that one was so low, I don't know anybody that would have swung at that pitch.
There's ball four.
Up next for Oakland, first baseman, Josh Olson.
Ready for another shot now, Matt Olson. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. He's set and the pitch.
Nope.
And that misses for ball one.
I wonder if that call not going his way right there has anything to do with walking the last guy. We all know umpires don't give you much on the corners if you're not throwing strikes consistently.
A runner at first with no outs here.
that's
the slider stayed low apparently for a ball.
Now with the 2-0 count and the power at the plate, it could be fireworks time. This is the kind of count he makes his money in.
The 2-0 on the way. Taken strike one.
You know, he fell behind 2-0, Matty, but he battled right there and got right back in this count. An aggressive fastball middle of the zone.
The 2-1. He pulls this one high and deep to right center field. Back goes Kiermaier at the track. Gone! Matt Olson connects for a two-run home run. And the 17th for him on the season, and the A's open it up 4-1 now.
I know I get big money for my expert analysis, but this is pretty simple. If you put a fastball up in the zone, over the heart of the plate, this guy's gonna turn it around in a heartbeat. This one was no shocker.
Jose Alvarado takes over on the mound here with nobody out in the sixth inning.
Number 46, Jose Alvarado.
Here's Matt Joyce now. And Dan, after that home run, it looks like they might be able to end this losing streak that they've been mired in.
Yeah, and the win at this point feels really good, especially when it's been a while. They're on their way if they can play well the rest of the game.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And that misses in the dirt for ball one.
D-Rock.
Couldn't wait back, a swing and a miss. Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. Got him.
Now batting, but designated hitter.
Ready once again. Steven Piscotty. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. From the stretch, here's the pitch. Neck-high fastball that time. Three runs already home here.
All two.
Here's a fastball inside as the count moves to 2-0 now.
That's a good approach when you're facing a young arm you might not be too familiar with. Take a look at a few and see what he's got. Now he's got himself ahead in the count.
Two and oh count and the pitch. Hit in the air down the right field line. And that is off the wall but in foul territory. Foul ball. Called strike two. Still only one out in the inning. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Piscotty is retired, two down now.
Now batting, third baseman.
Riding in once again, Matt Chapman. 0 for 2 from him so far in this one. ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Boom, that's out.
And a fastball's off the plate away. It's ball one. Slicing foul.
Might have been cheating for another fastball trying to get the head to that one early. Pitcher pulled the string with a nasty breaking ball and had him a little bit out in front.
The 1-1. Fly ball out toward right field. Echevarria has a play. And that ends the inning. Another good inning for the A's. Maybe the best fans in baseball right there, and they're loving it at the five and dime. More baseball on MLB Network right after this. Back here at the Coliseum in Oakland, the A's are on top in this one as we get set for the seventh. But before it gets underway, let's take a look at our game summary to this point. Ready for another chance? Wilson Ramos. He was a ground out victim last time up.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
First offering on its way. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike. Looks like a right-hander's gotten up to throw now in the Oakland pen.
Nope,
that's over,
bad.
But low, it's a ball and a strike. The 1-1 home. Waves and misses for strike number two.
Well, obviously somebody was hooting with the Owls last night. This entire roster, they've showed up for the first game of this road trip and are getting absolutely boat raced.
Count still at 1-2. Again, a 1-2. And
yep,
the slider runs away from him there, and the count levels at 2-2.
And it's late to his afternoon of work, and the longer this at-bat goes, the better chance of him making a mistake. But as a guy starts to tire, they're more likely to lead the ball up. But, man, he's been good so far.
There's one that misses inside, and the count's run full now, 3-2. Payoff pitch home. Just off the end of the bat, it's a foul ball, and he'll stick around. Another full count pitch on its way. But he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. He lined out in his last trip, so looking for better fortunes here. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. And it's grounded foul. And it's a ball and two strikes to Kiermaier now. Good hard sinker, but he lays off to even things at 2-2.
These last two guys are making him work quite a bit out there. Both have been long at bats, and all in all, he's had to make 13 throws just to them so far.
Now a swing and a chopper foul right at home plate. Here now the 2-2. Just hung in there on that one. The 2-2 one more time. It was laid off and the count runs full.
What we're seeing here is a really smart at bat. They got to be thinking the man on the mound is getting a little short on gas, so when you go up there and make him throw a bunch of pitches, you're more likely to get a good pitch to hit or at least force him out of the game.
And this misses here for ball four. Just the second walk he's issued here into his seventh inning of work.
Man, that's just painful for a pitcher right there. A 3-2 offering that was right on the corner, but he couldn't get him to chase, and he doesn't get the call. Can't beat yourself up about that one too much.
Here comes Bob Melvin now out of the Oakland dugout. And he's going to make a move, as that's going to be all for his starter this afternoon. So he'll head for the showers as he stands to win this one if the bullpen can find a way to protect his 3-1 lead.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the A's, number 46, Santiago Garcia.
In now, Carlos Gomez. And he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. A hit and two at-bats for him at this point in the ballgame. Now a throw over.
He's safe.
He just manages to get his hand in. Kiermaier, base runner at first with one out. Pitch up and in, keeping him honest. 1-1. Clearly trying to control the running game with the slide step here.
Yeah, that's a good way of trying to control the running game, Matt. The problem with it, though, it has a tendency to throw your command off because you're worrying about that runner on base.
The 1-1 is looked at for ball number two.
Well, that's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider. If it was a little closer, you might get a swing.
Runner goes for second. Pitch outside. The throw. He stays in there easily. The throw bounces on the way down. The 3-1. Swung on and missed, and that's strike two. Skied into straightaway right. And that's taken in straightaway right. Will he try from second? And he's up to third safely now with two gone in the inning.
How about it?
Digging in to try it again. Pesky. And with men on base and two away, it feels like this at-bat could go a long way toward deciding this thing.
No doubt, Matt. A base hit here changes this game quite a bit. But if they can't score here, it looks pretty bleak for them heading into the last couple of innings.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Shot weakly to the left. Chapman's got it. Throw to first will get him easily when the side is retired. Rays ran just the one. They trail it 4-1. Dan Jennings gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seven.
Dan Jennings.
At the plate, Bruce Maxwell, 0 for 2 for him.
Leading off for the Athletics, catcher, Bruce Maxwell.
Jump set, here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Hey. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. Jennings has a good reputation for preventing the long ball. One swing can change the complexion of the ball game when you're coming in late, but he rarely lets that happen. Part of what makes him as effective as he is. 0-1, here's the pitch. Tough one to lay off. Ball to strike. Two, here it comes. And
outside,
on 0-2,
he
misses ball. With a fastball. The 1-2. Swing on and miss, strike three.
Really good late bite on that slider right there. The best ones have that late action that just starts at the last minute. They're so tough to get the bat on, and when you've got that good slider going, it's a great strikeout pitch.
Into the box now, Steve Lombardozzi, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. Oh and one, here it comes. Fouled away. Two delivery.
Three.
And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen.
No problems for him on the mound since he's come out of the pen to start this inning. That's back-to-back K's, and he's making it look pretty easy. This has the makings of a good outing so far.
So two are gone now in the Oakland half of the seventh, and that'll bring in the shortstop, Jed Lowry. First pitch coming. Here it is. Swing and a miss just behind a lively fastball.
Hey, he's looking to punch out the side right here. And if this guy's going to do him favors and swing outside the zone, that's exactly what's going to happen.
0-2, the count to Jed Lowry. Trying to strike out the side. Here it is. And that one got a piece of it.
And I'm sure that one stings a little bit. The best revenge he can get for his pain is to find a way to come around to score. We'll see if his guys can move him around the bases.
Ken Griffey Jr. will stand in yet again as we flash you back to the middle innings. This was a turning point here. A solo home run that was really one of the key at-bats of the ballgame to this point. On the stretch. And a first pitch slider is right there for strike one.
That pitch was right down the heart of the plate, but obviously this guy had made up his mind on the on-deck circle. He was taken all away, and he was going to zone him up.
Here's the 0-1. A wave and a miss. So back-to-back sliders for strikes. Does he come back with yet another?
There's another slider. That's back-to-back good sliders, and this guy's breaking ball is really good, and when he's throwing it well like he is and he's confident with it, he can throw it 3 or 4 times in a row. A really good slider in this one.
That's a ball
shooting for that low inside corner, but yep, he missed with
one
it. One and two. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Span is under it. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. One left for Oakland. But they lead it 4-1.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Athletics, number 39, Blake Harlan.
So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Ladany Echevarria. He singled his last time.
Ladany Echevarria.
Here's the first pitch to him. Line hard, but foul.
He wasn't fooling anybody with that fastball. He barreled it up nice right there. He's just got to find a way to keep it fair.
Hit on the ground to short. Lowry's got it. In the dirt, and oh, he can't quite dig it out.
Man, as we take another look at this in slow motion, you can see that the first baseman makes a great effort to scoop it out of the dirt. Almost had it, but it squirts out of the pocket, and the man's on board with a throwing error.
Stepping in now, Brad Miller. As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. The 1-0 home is taken for ball two.
And the reason he's working away so much here is because he's got that big hole on the right side of the infield to worry about. With the first baseman holding the runner on, it's always smart to pitch into the defense you have behind you.
All over that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball. Echevarria gets his lead at first. Nobody out. Now he gets the ground ball to first. This might be two. Lowry,
he's out
on the first, and that's the very last thing they needed at this point in the ball game. There are two away now.
That's one of the hardest double plays to turn right there because of the difficult throw the first baseman has to make. No problem this time, though, and they get the two outs they were looking for.
Up next for the Rays, Denard Span. Two away here in the eighth, and time's running out on him, Danny.
Yeah, they don't have a lot of outs left to work with, so it's time for someone to make something happen if they're going to get back into this thing.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And that one stayed too low, apparently. Career against Blake Treinen. Just a couple of matchups, no hits in two at-bats. Stop foul right at home plate. The 1-1 home is put in play to the right side of the infield. Lombardozzi comes up with it. Throw on to first, and that error won't come back to haunt him after all as the inning is over. Nothing doing for Tampa, and this is still a 4-1 ball game. Daniel Hudson is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 48, Daniel Hudson.
Next will be the cleanup hitter, Chris Davis. One
leading off for the
ball game thus far.
Left fielder, Brad Davis.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Tough slider over the inside corner for a strike. Here's the 0-1 from Hudson. This is foul right side. Ball and two strikes now. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. With that, we'll give you a look at our starter comparison for the two starting pitchers in the game, and the column to look at is the one on the right side of your screen. Not too many hits to go around at this point in the ballgame. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Yeah, that last at-bat, Daddy, he turned that fastball around. He didn't hit it a ton. He didn't hit it a country mile, but, hey, listen, a home run is a home run.
He's set. Here it comes. Ball, and that one just missed outside.
Backdoor breaking ball just missed right there. It's such an effective pitch if you can hit the corner with it, but no dice this time.
Eighth inning. 4-1 is our score. Swung on and missed. 1-1. Laid off for ball two. Now a southpaw up to throw in that Tampa Bay bullpen. Now the 2-2 is a called strike three on the corner.
Now batting right fielder.
Here's Matt Joyce now. He went down on strikes last time up. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike. Grounder down the line at third. This will get foul for strike two.
Ball.
It's 1-2.
One ball.
As a hitter, you got to be staunch in your game plan. You know he has a nasty changeup, and you got to fight to make sure it's in the zone. That's a great take right there.
The 1-2. Swung on and missed. He got him on strikes. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. Don't touch that remote. More on MLB Network right after this.
Your attention, please.
Takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door.
Number 31, Liam Hendricks.
Riding in, Matt Duffy earned himself an RBI with a sack fly his last time.
Listen, it's not easy coming back off the closers, but this guy hasn't been super dependable so far this season, and he's blown several saves up to this point.
Hit hard to the right, but foul. Wind up. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. And he fouls this one off. Another 0-2 home.
You know, Matty, I'm not surprised by that pitch. Raise the eye level a little bit. Maybe we get something bouncing in the third right here.
Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. The 1-2. And he'll stay alive here as this is chopped foul at the plate. It will remain 1-2. Again, another foul ball. The 1-2. It's a fastball in off the plate for a ball.
After multiple pitches were fouled off, it gets a little disappointing as a pitcher. So you think, say, I'm going to throw one way off the plate and see if he'll chase it. Didn't happen.
Pop foul, and it looks like that's going to make it into the VIP seats.
I didn't realize the pitcher and the hitter were being so charitable today, giving away 7 free souvenirs to the fans. This is one of those epic at-bats. Everyone wins.
Got him to miss the breaking ball there. Matt Duffy was retired to kick off the ninth.
That strikeout was a real good example of a pitcher continuing to make a guy chase out of the zone. When you recognize a hitter is in protect mode, you don't have to come inside the strike zone. You can just expand further and further until he literally can't touch it.
Below the knees, one ball, no strikes. Up. Here comes the 1-0. Curveball that gets a swing and a miss and makes him look way behind.
Hey, this offense needs to get it going right here. Somebody has to take it upon themselves to have a quality AB and get this team to start thinking past the common power. They cannot continue to go up there and look like they have no game.
Count moves to a ball and 2 strikes now. Breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And the throw is made to record the second out of the inning.
Well, you have to feel pretty confident about the way this one's going to end up as a manager. 2 hitters, 2 strikeouts from the closer. There's not a whole lot more he can do to instill confidence that he's going to wrap this thing up without any problem.
Here's the catcher, Wilson Ramos. First pitch to him runs a bit inside for ball 1. He's got a hit in 3 at-bats to this point. The windup and the 1-0 pitch. And they won't get him to chase the curveball in the dirt that time, and it's 2-0 now.
The last thing you want to do when you've got a 3-run lead in the ninth is give the other guys any sense of hope. It's a good time to challenge here on 2-0, especially since there's a good chance he's taking until he gets a strike.
3-0 to him now. There's a fastball right over the inside corner. 2 out, nobody on. Bounced softly in front of the plate. Going to first would be in time to take care of him. Andy Abe taking the opener here at home, and this ball game is over.
It's always nice to take the opener before being set when you're home. That sets the stage for the rest of the series, and it gives you a good springboard the rest of the way.
And the score finishes 4-1 today. The A's rode an important 6th inning to victory in this one. Andrew Triggs gets the win on the mound, his first of the year. Liam Hendricks closes the door for the save, his 15th of the campaign. So that's a wrap for us here this afternoon. For Mark, Dan, and the rest of our crew, I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB Network.
Here now is our final line for the day. First for the victorious Athletics. 4 runs on 6 hits. With 1 error, they left 5 men on base. For the Rays, 1 run, 4 hits, no errors, they left 4 men on base. Time of the ball game, 2 hours and 53 minutes. A reminder that extra BART train service is available on the Fremont Daily City Line or on the Fremont Richmond Line. by accessing the ramp directly outside the stadium beyond the left field wall. AC Transit will also be available.